In this lesson, we're going to look at the nature of oxidation reduction. Specifically, we're going to look to see how we identify a reaction as an oxidation or reduction in process in terms of a couple of different things: the gain or loss of electrons, or the gain or loss of oxygen or hydrogen atoms. So when we look at redox, there are a few things we notice. We always see that oxidation and reduction happen in pairs. We cannot have one without the other. The main thing that we look for when we're looking at redox is looking at the transfer of electrons. Something that loses electrons will be an oxidation. Something that gains electrons is a reduction. Anytime there's an oxidation or reduction, what we see is that there is always a transfer of electrons. For some reactions, for the transfer of electrons can be a bit more challenging, particularly looking at organic or biological chemistry reactions. When we look at those, sometimes it's easier to look at it in terms of oxygen and hydrogen atoms. So we say there's always a transfer of electrons, even if we can't readily see it, in a redox reaction. Sometimes the easier way to identify those are through the gain or loss of oxygen or hydrogen. Now, sometimes we will be able to see both the gain of oxygen and a loss of hydrogen, or vice versa. Sometimes the most immediate thing is simply a gain of oxygen or a loss of hydrogen. So we don't have to see both of them in order to identify it as a redox reaction. As we will see, many of our biological reactions don't in fact show a balanced chemical equation. Often species such as water are omitted from the equation. Now, from looking at the types of reactions, we talked about the suffix "-ation," meaning to add. So if I look at this, an oxidation is gaining oxygen, so that's the addition of oxygen. Sometimes we can easily see that the gain of oxygen is also accompanied by the loss of a hydrogen atom, one or more hydrogen atoms. If we look on the other side, the reduction part of the reaction, which remember, oxidation and reduction must always happen in pairs. For a reduction, we see the loss of oxygen and the gain of hydrogen. So the definition of oxidation and reduction is based on the electrons, but the oxygen and hydrogen options sometimes make it easier to see where those electrons are being gained and lost, when it's easier to count oxygen and hydrogen than it is to determine oxidation numbers. So when we look at an oxidation, even if we identify it based on the gain of oxygen or the loss of hydrogen, we know that there's also the loss of electrons. For reduction, if we see a loss of oxygen or a gain of hydrogen, we know that a reduction has occurred. And even if we can't actually see where it's happening, we know that there's also a gain of electrons. So we gain electrons, we are gaining negative charge, and so the oxidation number will be reduced. So here are a couple of mnemonics to help you remember redox. So the first of which is oil rig. So oxidation is loss of electrons, reduction is gain of electrons. Leo the lion says grr, so lose electrons oxidation, gain electrons reduction. So this only refers to what's happening with the electrons, not dealing with the oxygen and hydrogens, because remember, redox is specifically defined as the transfer of electrons. The hydrogen and oxygen just become an easier way to identify if redox has occurred in some reactions. So let's look at an example here of oxidation, and you should select one from each pair. So we have oxidation, and so when we have an oxidation, we are going to see a loss of electrons. And so we are going to see an increase in our oxidation number. And so that's our second one, is an increase in oxidation number. Because again, if I lose electrons, I'm losing negative charge. And so my oxidation number will increase. We also see that oxidation is the gain of oxygen or the loss of hydrogen. Notice that the gain of oxygen and loss of hydrogen are always paired. The loss of oxygen and the gain of hydrogen are always paired. We will never see a redox reaction where we have the gain of both oxygen and hydrogen.